Hello everybody, welcome to today's class, that is about national integration, importance and necessity. In this class, we'll first have an introduction, importance of national integration, essence of national integration, necessity of national integration, and lastly, as usual, conclusion. Coming to introduction, national integration means feeling of togetherness and unity and unity among the people of the country. It also means an atmosphere in which all citizens, irrespective of their caste, religion and region, live together peacefully. It refers to integration in all respects, social, socio-political, economical and emotional in an integrated country. People share common goals. They work together and cooperate with each other for the prosperity of the nation. No country can survive if its people do not remain united. The feeling of togetherness and sense of belonging are absolutely necessary for a nation to survive. Such a feeling can only be granted through the process of integration. Thus, national integration is a positive concept which provides strength to the people to fight against all evil forces. NCC, one of the prime organizations in the country, training the youth, the future of this great nation, makes the ideal ground to start with. National integration has been made part and parcel of NCC training. Lot of emphasis is laid on national integration by conducting national level camps and number of other activities where cadets from all over the country participate. Essence of national integration. National integration is emotional and spiritual bond which binds all Indians irrespective of caste, creed, color, region, race. Being a good citizen of the country in its true sense is what national integration is all about. In fact, national integration and national branding are synonymous. National integration include the following things: culture integration, economical integration, unemployment and underemployment of people, inflation and farmer disaster are the major hurdles for economical integration. Political integration, religious integration and social integration. We'll come to know one by one. Cultural integration is a form of cultural exchange in which one group assumes the beliefs and practices and rituals of other group without sacrificing the characteristic of its own culture. It is generally looked upon as a positive because nothing is lost. See from this light, cultural integration is healthy intermingling of the beliefs and rituals of two unique cultures. Economical integration. The precipitation of the common man in India is that generally, the poor are becoming poorer and the rich are richer. It is an open question whether equal social and economical justice is available to all segments of the society. However, the economic injustice gives rise to indifferent tendency in the society. These people are always ripped for misguidance and kept them in mainstream. Economic integration is essential. Various resources for economical inequality are one of the major inequalities of economical growth are unemployment, underemployment of people, inflation, and former distress. Unemployment and underemployment is the main reason for low income of majority of Indian people in people is unemployment and underemployment. Sufficient employment could not be created through the processes of planning economic development. It was not possible to increase the income level of most people. Inflation. Another cause of inequality is inflation. During inflation, few profit earns gains. During inflation, few profit earners gain and most wage workers lose. This is exactly what happens in India. This has created more and more inequality, and this leads to a fall in the standard of living of poor people since their purchasing power falls. Former distress. No doubt, India's new agriculture strategy has led to green revolution and raised agriculture products, but the benefits of high productivity are enjoyed mainly by rich farmers and landowners. At the same time, the economic condition of landless workers and marginal farmers are deteriorated over the years. Most farmers in India could not enjoy the benefits of high agriculture productivity. As a result, inequality in the distribution of income of the rural areas has increased. Political integration. Politics need to be separated from religion. Strict law must be enforced against exploitation of the common man by the politician and vested interest. This can be achieved only through correct understanding of different political ideologies being practiced by politicians from different backgrounds. Religious integration. Our constitution permits practice of individual religions without hurting or offending the religious sentiments and beliefs of others. The need is to understand the existing commonalities in the principle and teaching of all the religions to develop positive attitude towards religion. The correct understanding and interpretation of our own religion and faith will automatically help in developing mutual respect for each other's religion, leading to religious harmony and tolerance in the country. Social integration. Social integration is movement of minority groups such as ethnic minorities, unprivileged sections of our society into mainstream of societies. Social integration requires proficiency in an accepted common language of society, acceptance of laws of the society, and adoption of common set of values of the society. Provide provisions of equal rights and opportunity has been granted through our constitution. Necessity of national integration. India has a rich culture heritage characterized by tolerance, compassion, and synthesis. After independence, our country adopted for secularism and equal opportunity for all, but vested interest and diverse forces under the cover of communal organization and political parties exploit and spread casteism, communalism, regionalism, religious bigotry, intolerance, linguistic, and so on, for their narrow and immediate interests and sacrifice national interest. To fight this growing, it is the scared duty of every Indian to work for national integration. National integration is necessary, particularly in a country like India, where people with different languages, religions, race, and culture are required to be viewed together. The unity in diversity for which we are proud of can only be maintained if we have understanding and respect for each other's religion, customs, and tradition. If we have to survive as a nation and safeguard our society and nation integrity, we have to remain united. National integration is prerequisite for survival and prosperity of any nation, and hence need no emphasis. National integration is therefore a basic necessity for survival of any nation through the following means. National integration is survival of any national of any nation through the following means: maintenance of peace and harmony, growth and development of the nation, law and order, cultural and religious development, dignity and self-respect, welfare and well-being of the people. Maintenance of peace and harmony. Peace and harmony between the people of the nation can be achieved only through the feeling of togetherness among the people. Growth and development of the nation. National integration is a process through equally understood by all citizens of the nation, which subsequently led to the national achieve the growth and development. Law and order. Provisions of equal rights and opportunities can be ensured only through proper awareness of the prevailing law. It will lead to proper maintenance of law and order situation. Culture and religious development. Our constitution permits practice of individual religion without hurting the belief of the others. National integration is essential for developing mutual respect for each other religion. Dignity and self-respect. Every citizen must be dealt with equal dignity. Mutual respect and dignity will develop only if we believe it and practice it. Welfare and well-being of the people. Welfare of the masses can be achieved only through proper understanding between the people, and it can be achieved through the process of oneness. National integration is the awareness of common identity among the citizens of the country. It means that though we belong to different caste, religion and region and speak different languages, we recognize the fact that we are all one. National festivals act as an important unifying force. The national festivals like Independence Day, Republic Day, Gandhi Jayanti, etc. are the festivals that are celebrated by all Indians and in all parts of the country, regardless of their religion, language, culture. They remind us of our common nationality. On Republic Day, we stress on the importance of showing proper respect to the nation. Republic Day camp of NCC provide ample opportunity to the youth of the country to meet and share their respective culture and the promotion of national integration. Lastly, coming to the conclusion, it is the duty of every citizen of the country to strive to achieve unity in spite of diversity and further maintain it. We must remember that there should be no division between different parts of the country. There is only one India to which we all Indians are inheritors. We are Indians first and Indians last. The unity in diversity of which we are proud of can only be maintained if we have understanding, respect to each other, religion, customs and tradition. We all know that national integration includes the following: cultural integration, economical integration, political integration, religious integration and social integration. National integration is survival of any nation through the following means: maintaining peace and harmony, law and order, growth and development, and cultural and religious development, dignity of self-respect and well-being of the people. Okay, this is about national integration and its importance. If you have any doubts, you can text me or call me. Thank you.